Well, good Saturday morning to you folks. Hopefully things are going well with you. I hope you had a good night's rest and you're ready to face the day. We had a good jam last night at the church. It was good to see at the fellowship hall. It was good to see the folks that came out. And if you didn't get to make it, maybe you will the next time. Tonight is our Saturday night revival service at 6 o'clock at Charity Free Will Baptist. If you want to come out and be with us, we'd love to have you. George Lohr will be preaching. Samuel Lohr will be singing tonight. April 20th from Revival Today. God never leaves us nor forsakes us. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. Isaiah 43:2. David Brainerd, the sacrificial missionary to the American Indians, was born April 20th, 1718, in Haddam, Connecticut, to Hezekiah and Dorothy Brainerd. David grew up with 9 siblings and at a young age lost his father. 5 years later, his mother died also, and David was left orphaned at the age of 14. He no doubt wrestled with what his future would hold. He would later attend Yale, but was kicked out for criticizing a professor. David would soon develop a great burden for the mysterious American Indian and would be used of God to inspire millions of future missionaries. One incident sealed in his heart a burden for the Native Americans. F.W. Borum described the moment when the Indians were watching Brainerd, ready to kill him. But when the braves drew closer to Brainerd's tent, they saw the paleface on his knees, and as he prayed, suddenly a rattlesnake slipped in to his side, lifted up its ugly head to strike, flicked its forked tongue almost in his face, and then, without an apparent reason, glided swiftly away into the brush. The great spirit is what is with Paleface, the Indian said. And thus they accorded him a prophet's welcome. What do you face today that causes you worry or fear? Have friends or family forsaken you? Have your resources run out? Are you unsure what the future holds? Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. That is Philippians 4, 6 and 7. David Brainerd only lived to the age of 29, but God was with him every step of the way, and his short life still impacts ours today. Well, I was thinking about this song, so I'll just do it. I know sometimes something just go through my mind, and sometimes I'll deny doing it, but maybe someone today needs this song. So I know there are a lot of folks that seem to enjoy it, but... Well, I'm tired and so weary, but I must go along. Till the Lord comes and calls me away. And the morning's so bright, and the Lamb is the light, and the night is as black as the sea. Oh yes, there will be valley for me someday. There will be peace in the valley for me, oh Lord, I pray. There'll be no sadness, no sorrow, no trouble I see. There will be peace in the valley for me. Well, the bear will be gentle And the wolf will be tame, and the lions will lay down with the lamb. And the beast from the wild will be led by a child. And I will be changed from this creature that I am. Oh yes, there will be peace in the valley for me someday. There will be peace in the valley for me, dear Lord, I pray. There'll be no sadness, no sorrow, no trouble I see. There will be peace in the valley for me. Lord, I thank you for the day you've given us, Lord. And God, I thank you for the days that we can experience a little rest here and some peace. But we know the peace that you give brings the most comfort to us. And one day we will be at peace forever. Here we do have turmoil and trouble and strife at times. And the only real peace that we do have is still in you, of course. But there will be no more struggle. We'll be changed from the creature that we are now, the song says. Lord, I love you and I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, folks. If you'll watch Sunday, of course, you'll see our services. Come back Monday. God bless. If we're still living, we'll be right here. God bless.